Hello friends, welcome back to Neet with Bioscience. Today we are going to start a very important topic of lipid metabolism, that is beta oxidation of fatty acid. First we will see what is the definition of beta oxidation of fatty acid and why this name has been given. Beta oxidation of fatty acid means what? It is actually the catabolic process where the breakdown of the fatty acid will take place, and ultimately we will get products like acetyl CoA, FADH2 and NADH. Okay, so it is a catabolic process where the oxidation of fatty acid will take place and we will get the product like this. And we are aware of the electron transport chain and the TCA cycle. So what will happen? This FADH2 and NADH generate here, will enter the electron transport chain and generate the ATP, and this acetyl CoA then enter the TCA cycle. Here also we will get NADH and FADH2, and finally we will get the ATP. So the main purpose of oxidation of fatty acid is to generate the energy. Though carbohydrate is the primary source of energy production or the energy storage, but in the animal body the large percentage of the energy reserve is in the form of the lipid, means in the fat deposit, which is having the high energy fatty acid. So the fatty acid breakdown will take place there when there is a high need of energy. And when there will be the high need of energy? When the blood glucose will go down, or when there is a prolonged fasting stage. Yeah, so when there is a prolonged fasting stage, so the fatty acid deposited in the adipose tissue, it will get breakdown. Yeah, means first the lipolysis and everything will take place, that we will discuss later. So when there is a blood glucose will go down, on when there is an energy requirement, so fatty acid oxidation will take place and it will provide the energy. If we consider the per gram percentage, so energy generated from the per gram of carbohydrate and per gram of the fat, so per gram of carbohydrate it will give the 4 kilocalorie per gram, that is carbohydrate. And fat metabolism, it will give approximately 9 kilocalorie per gram. So the larger percentage of energy reserve is in the form of the fat, and when the fat breakdown will take place, it will produce the large sum of energy. Yeah, that we'll discuss the how, because already we are seeing here the this acetyl CoA NADH, and we are getting so much acetyl CoA NADH and FADH2. So here we will get the major ATP production, or the large energy produced during the oxidation here. So first let us discuss why this name has been given, beta oxidation. If we take the example of any fatty acid, we know the fatty acid structure. At the one end there is a carboxylic group, and there will be the another methyl end, and suppose R is the hydrocarbon chain. So while doing the numbering, we had discussed that the first number given to the carboxylic group, and the so on, then second, first carbon, second, third, and so on. And the carbon next to the carboxylic group, the name has been given as a alpha carbon, then the next is a beta carbon, and so on. So during this oxidation, in this process, it is this carbon, beta carbon, which is undergoing into oxidation, and it will oxidize into carbonyl group. Therefore the process name has been given as a beta oxidation of fatty acid. Understood? It is a beta carbon which is undergoing into the oxidation and into carbonyl group, so the name has been given beta oxidation of fatty acids. There are also the alpha oxidation, beta oxidation, omega oxidation, but the most important one is the beta oxidation of fatty acid. Okay, this is the beta oxidation of the fatty acid. It is the provide the major percentage of energy to the some tissues like skeletal muscle, के कार्डियक मसल, किडनी, लीवर, दीज आर सम ऑर्गन्स वेयर द बीटा ऑक्सीडेशन, प्राइमरीली द बीटा ऑक्सीडेशन विल टेक्स प्लेस एंड इट विल प्रोड्यूस द एनर्जी फॉर दिस ऑर्गन्स. सो द ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ फैटी एसिड्स विल ऑकर इन द वेरियस रीजन्स विद इन द सेल. लेट अस टेक द एग्जाम्पल. सो विद इन द सेल इट मे टेक्स प्लेस इन माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया विच इज बीटा ऑक्सीडेशन which we are going to discuss. So the site of beta oxidation is in the mitochondria of the cell. Then peroxisome, where alpha and beta oxidation both will take place. Very long chain fatty acid, if suppose it is having the carbon between the 24 to 26, so the very long chain fatty acid oxidation will take place in the peroxisomes, and omega oxidation, it is takes place in the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so these are the site we are focusing here in the beta oxidation. So the site of the beta oxidation of fatty acids, it is in the mitochondria of the cell. Understood? Now there are the various sources of fatty acid. For example, the fatty acid which is present in the diet in the form of the triglyceride, so it will be transported after having the diet from the intestine, it will be transported to the various organ by the specific protein, because fatty acid cannot transport in the blood. It will need some carrier protein. So the carrier protein for the fatty acid which is present in the diet, for that it is chylomicron. Then second one, which is most important and that we will discuss in our process, it is the fatty acid which is stored in the adipose tissue. So this is very important. In the adipose tissue, it is present in the form of the triacylglycerol. Alright, triacylglycerol. So there are some hormone sensitive lipases are there. When the blood glucose level goes down, so some hormone will secrete like glucagon, epinephrine. This hormone will give the signals and it will activate the protein kinases, and this protein kinases then it will activate the hormone sensitive lipases, and these lipases will break down the triacylglycerol into fatty acid and glycerol. Alright, and this will then come out into the circulatory system. So this way the fatty acid, it will get from the which is deposited into adipose tissue in the form of the triacylglycerol. So this fatty acid, it is transported in the blood via serum albumin. Okay, so the first fatty acid can be obtained from the diet, that is transported by chylomicrons. If it is deposited, if it is obtained from the fat deposit or from the adipose tissues, then it will be transported by the albumin, and fatty acid may synthesize in the liver, and that will be the transported by the very low density lipoproteins. Third is a, this is first, second, and the third, which is fatty acid may be synthesized in the liver and which is transported by very low density lipoprotein. Okay, so we will focus mainly on this, the fatty acid which is obtained from the adipose tissue. Okay, so it will be transported by the serum albumin. Now let us see the overview of beta oxidation of fatty acid. So when the beta oxidation of the fatty acid will take place, we had already discussed that we will get the intermediates product like FADH2 and NADH. It will enter into electron transport chain and ultimately it will generate the ATP. And as fatty acid beta oxidation of fatty acid will take place, at the end we will get fatty acyl CoA and acetyl CoA, acetyl coenzyme A. Okay, so this, it is a 2-carbon compound. This will, we had discussed that it will enter into TCA cycle. So that means 2-carbon is removing from the fatty acid, and this again will enter into beta oxidation. Then again same process will take place and the 2-carbon acetyl CoA will be removed. So likewise, in every round, there will be the 6 or 7 rounds depending upon the which type of the fatty acid. If it is a palmitic acid having the 16 carbons, so this cycle will repeat it for the 7 time. If it is a stearic acid having the 18 carbon atoms, so where 8 times this cycle will be repeated. So in every cycle, 2 carbon atoms will be removed in the form of the acetyl CoA. And same process will take place. So the repetition will take place and there will be the removal of the 2 carbons. Suppose if this is a some fatty acid, so every time there will be the breakdown and the, this will be removed in the form of acetyl CoA. Again the beta oxidation will take place, then 2 carbon atoms will be removed in the form of the acetyl CoA. So likewise this process will take place depending upon the chain length of the fatty acid. Generally the long chain fatty acids, saturated long chain fatty acid, it is undergo into the beta oxidation of fatty acid. Okay, so 2 carbon atoms will be removed. So if it is a palmitic acid, so 7 times this cycle will be repeated. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 times this cycle will be removed and we will get the likewise the acetyl CoA and NADH and FADH2. And ultimately we will get the ATP. Yeah, so this is the basic principle or the basic step of beta oxidation of fatty acid. We just understand this, that beta oxidation will take place. Ultimately we are getting the acetyl CoA, NADH and FADH2. And finally we are getting the ATP. So likewise 2 carbon atoms will be removed. Now depending upon the tissue type where this process will take place, if it is a cardiac muscle or skeletal muscles, so during the exercise when there is a need of the energy, so this acetyl CoA, then it will enter into the TCA cycle. But if it is a hepatocytes, means it is a liver, then this acetyl CoA, it will help in the production of the ketone bodies. Okay, so this will take place in the cardiac muscle or skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscle, and if it is a hepatocytes or the liver cell, then it will help in the production of the ketone bodies. Okay, so this is the basic idea of beta oxidation of fatty acid. Okay, now as we had discussed, we will consider the fatty acid which is obtained from the adipose tissue. So let us consider this is some cell, and we had already discussed where beta oxidation will take place. It is in the mitochondria. Suppose this is the outer membrane of mitochondria, inner membrane of mitochondria, and the beta oxidation will take place in the matrix of mitochondria. Okay, and this is the cell cytoplasm. So what we had discussed, first in the adipose tissue we will get this triacylglycerol will break down into fatty acid and glycerol. Okay, this fatty acid is then transported by serum albumin. Okay, and if serum albumin, with the help of serum albumin, it will reach to the cell, but it cannot cross the membrane of the cell. So there will be some transported proteins are there, and which will transport the fatty acid, and after the transportation the activation of fatty acid will take place. So the first step is the activation of fatty acid, transport and activation of fatty acid in the cell. Okay, first is the transport and the activation of fatty acid in the cells. We will discuss everything, enzymes names and everything. Just this class we will have in the overview. Activation means entry and the activation. Next, this fatty acid has to enter into mitochondria, but it cannot cross the mitochondrial membranes. So there is a special type of the shuttle system is there, which is known as a carnitine shuttle system. Okay, so with the help of the carnitine shuttle systems, it will enter into the matrix of mitochondria. So second step is the transport in mitochondria, and then in the matrix region proper beta oxidation will take place. So these are the three basic steps. First is the activation, means obviously first is the transport, then in the cells activation, then transport in the mitochondria, and then the proper beta oxidation will take place in the matrix region. Okay, so this is the overview of beta oxidation of fatty acid. Yeah, the major source of major goal or the purpose of beta oxidation of fatty acid is to generate the energy during the fasting stage. This is the basic idea. Alright, okay, so next class we will discuss all these three processes in the details with the enzymes names and the intermediates. Okay. I hope this video is useful to you. If you're finding it useful, then please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.